to our final episode of Science News Network. We've had episodes of creatures ranging from birds to reptiles to this week's episode, which is mammals. So sit back and relax as we bring you the final episode of
Science News Network.
So let's jump into our first segment, which is our music video. And I think Sarah is actually in this one.
Yes, I am. I am going to be singing Here Without Harambe.
The date was May 28th, 2016. An innocent gorilla was shot. He was only 17, an unsupervised kid. This could not have been foreseen. Forgotten by most, but he'll live on in my dreams. Harambe was trying to help. The kid would only resist. With one poor decision, 440 pounds ceased to exist. Rest in peace, Harambe. You truly will be missed.
Still on my lonely mind, I think about Harambe and I dream about him all the time. I'm here without Harambe, but he's still with me in my dreams tonight. It's Harambe and me.
You shoot a gorilla, the public will make you a villain. But get your good reason, you're involved in the kill. You're already in danger, it's not like there's a million in a protest pile up from the floor to the ceiling. Saying, how could you do this? Do you have no family? Squirrels ain't a dime a dozen. And don't be surprised when you shoot and we all come buzzing. We're so close to your neighbor, you could have been your cousin. And don't mess with these gorillas that I've been loving.
Still on my lonely mind, I think about Harambe and I dream about him all the time. I'm here without Harambe, but he's still with me in my dreams tonight. It's Harambe.
Today's sports news, we have the cheetahs versus the impalas.
With cheetahs topping in at speeds of 68 to 70 miles per hour and impalas topping out at 50 miles per hour.
The cheetahs have a stride of 6.7 meters and the impalas have a stride of 2.5 meters high and 10 meters in length. Now let's introduce our runners.
Now introducing team one, the cheetahs.
And team number two, the impalas.
Now to the track.
So how was the race?
It was cheetah cheese.
Cheetah cheese. No day in the life of track, you know what I'm saying?
Easy, man.
You know.
So, how'd the race go?
Oh, not too well. I mean, our leadoff guy, he got off to a bad start. He didn't really get to practice that much with his block, so we didn't we didn't think he would need them, and he just didn't get that power going.
Because so, I'm white.
I mean, part of that.
Well, Carter, what did you think of that race?
Well, Tyler, the Impalas may have longer strides, but have less speed, whereas the Cheetahs put more strides down in less time.
I couldn't agree more, Carter. Big thank you to our runners, Cole, Kelly, Justin, Kyle, Colin, myself, Carter, and Logan.
Sarah, wasn't that race intense?
Not as intense as Harambe dying. Rest in peace. So let's just move on to our questions. What's your favorite kind of dog?
American Bulldog.
Pitbull.
A Pitbull.
Australian Shepherd.
A Pitbull. American Bulldog.
Pitbull.
A Chihuahua.
A Rat Terrier.
A Rat Terrier?
Yeah. They kind of look like naked cats, but they're dogs.
The gray whale.
Yes.
Cuddles.
They eat grass.
It plays catch. The frisbee. It swims.
12 years.
10 to 13, so yeah.
10 years.
10 to 13.
80 years.
10 to 13.
20 years.
Dog unless Max.
It's Canis Lupus
Vermilius.
Yes. 12 hours a day.
17 hours.
12 to 14 hours.
10 hours.
Yes. 26.
42.
So let's travel around the world and check out the different types of mammals.
They're everywhere!
I'm Megan.
And I'm Bailey.
Coming at you with some travel!
Dolphins are well known, but do you know where they live? Some may think they're only in oceans and seas, but that's not the case. Four species live in rivers. The two most known live in tropical rivers of South America. There are nearly 40 species of dolphins that live all over the globe. The only places that don't live are the polar regions. Except for one species, the orca, which lives close to both the Arctic and Antarctic oceans. The best place to go to see dolphins are Portuguese Azores, Florida, New Zealand, the Bahamas, Hawaii, and Australia. The Portuguese Azores Archipelago have the largest variety of dolphin species, with a population up to 1,000, and they come close to the shore because of feeding opportunities. In Florida, you can see the dolphins plus dolphinariums. New Zealand watchers and swimmers alike are almost guaranteed to come across friendly dusky dolphins. In the Bahamas, depending on the time of year, you'll either see bottlenose dolphins, Atlantic spotted dolphins, spinner dolphins, brittle dolphins, or striped dolphins. In Hawaii, you can see spinner and spotter dolphins, and they are known to ride the waves with the surfers and put on air shows for those hanging back on the shore. Off the coast of Australia, you're most likely to find the common dolphins, the bottlenose dolphin, which is the one that most people think of when they hear the word dolphin. All right, this has been Megan.
And Bailey.
Now, back to you, Sarah and Austin.
So I keep the excess stuff in my belly. I'm an alpha wolf, so I form a single file line with my pack, and the pups are in the back. To conserve energy during winter, I follow the same trail as the prey, staying upwind and out of sight. When they're about to strike, I wag my tails in excitement, and sometimes the pups will get too excited and dash after the prey. Wolves are more likely to hunt young, sick, or older mammals past their prime. If they have a good opportunity, they will hunt strong, healthy animals as well. During the spring, both male and female wolves will devote their time to digging or remodeling an existing den. The dens are used for birthing and rear the young, and which are usually on elevated, it's near water, Mississippi River. It's oval shaped. The wolf's gestation period is 63 days. I hunt with the pack until a week or two before birth, and then I stay just around the den for a little bit. During the summer, that's my time for growth. I have a short summer coat, not at all like what it is now. I need to shed it. Pups are still using the den. Me, I started hunting with the pack again. The pups learned how to hunt. Most of their activity takes place at night to avoid the heat. It's hot. During the autumn, they start to prepare for winter again and their coat becomes deep and dense. The pups become part of the pack to hunt and the pack migrates with their prey. The fall is a natural dispersal time for most wild animals. Goodbye.
Now, it is our final segment of our final episode. Our personal top 10 lists.
Top 10 most wanted mammals. Number 10, bears. Bears kill on average 10 humans yearly. Number 9, horses. Horses kill 20 humans yearly on average. Number 8, platypuses. A platypus poison can leave a man sick for weeks at a time. Number 7, a honey badger. Honey badgers are the most aggressive animals on the planet. Number 6, deer. Deer kill 120 humans yearly on average. Number 5, a tiger. Tigers kill up to 250 humans yearly. Number 4, dogs. Dogs kill 400 humans yearly. So much for a man's best friend, ha ha ha. Number 3, elephants. Elephants can kill up to 500 humans yearly. Number 2, lions. Lions kill approximately 500 humans yearly. And number 1, a hippopotamus. Hippopotamus are massive killers and kill up to 1,000 humans yearly.
So thank you everyone for not only tuning in to this week's episode of Science News Network, but all of our episodes of Science News Network.
It's been a joy, and I'm really gonna miss everybody. Even Sarah.
So, I won't say tune in next week, because that's not a thing, but we hope you enjoy your summer, and we'll be back next year.
That's a wrap.